I want to say those are the untreated peanuts. If you just take a look at those, try to visualize what they are. A little bit of injury here with Garoxum and Bascarin by itself. Not a whole lot, I mean, at this point in time. But really, not seeing a whole lot of injury at this point. So some transient injury. And again, this is with Zidua, but there's no real, that stam reduction wasn't caused by Zidua. And again, this is the Anthem Flex. So we'll talk more about at some point at some of our production meetings, the crop response to Anthem Flex, but at least in this study, no major issues when mixed with Gramoxone and Bascarin. So control at 6 weeks after. So this is really looking at what happened well into the season. And here's the non-treated control. A lot of ragweed, but some other weeds as well. Things are really great. Gramoxone by itself. And then here's an example with Warrant. Again, we see some ragweed in here. And a few other weeds as well. If you remember, the Texas Panic Control had dropped off some with the Warrant. This is with Outlook. This is with Zidua. And again, this is that poor stand on the left, but again, that's due to the planting and some of the seed ran out before we caught that. And this is the Anthem Flex. So that treatment looks quite good. And no injury to speak of when mixed with Gramoxone and Bascarin. Later in the year, at production meetings and so forth, I'll show some data that's got these residual materials mixed with Gramoxone plus Storm, which is a very popular treatment in the Southeast. We did some of that up here as well. That's, to me, when you start putting Gramoxone and Storm, which would have some blazer, and then with Anthem Flex, I think you can get a bit more injury, but we'll talk about that at another point in time. So what about Palmer Amaranth, one of our most important weeds? We do not have that particular weed at the Peanut Belt Station in Lewiston. Now, Palmer Amaranth is very important across the state, but as we move up in the northeastern part of the state, ragweed is one of our very important weeds too. So we get a lot of information at Lewiston-Woodville on ragweed, and also the Texas Panicum is very popular or very abundant there. At the Upper Coastal Plain Station, we have Palmer Amaranth. So in general, what we've seen is not a great deal of difference in the control of Palmer Amaranth with the residual herbicides that I've shown here. And again, you could even say that to a degree with what I showed with common ragweed and morning glories and so forth at our Lewiston station. If you look at the actual numbers, now you could look at those photographs, you might see some different things from one replication, but from a scientific standpoint, it's important for things to rep out and to consider all four replications. And in some of those cases for the weeds, we didn't see a lot of difference. And I think that's been the general consensus with Palmer Amaranth. But again, I'll talk about some of the data we have with the Storm Gramoxone mixtures at another time. Couple other things I wanted to talk about for the field day today is looking at the compatibility of clethodim with two fungicides, Miravis plus Convoy or Elatus. So one of the things that a lot of folks are doing right about now is making fungicide applications. They often have some weeds that are in fields. It's not uncommon to have grass weeds, and we apply a lot of clethodim to control that. We can have broadleaf weeds too. So one of my thoughts was that Miravis is one of the newer materials that's out there. It's a very good leaf spot material. It is applied with either Convoy or Elatus to get stem rot control. So I wanted to look at the compatibility of those materials. Again, we put these materials out at 15 gallons per acre, 31 PSI, 110-02 flat fan nozzles to get good control. Now in these studies, we put Cobra out about a week before to control the broadleaf weeds so that we had predominantly Texas Panicum at this location that we didn't have interference of the herbicide sprays with the Miravis and Convoy because of the ragweed and other weeds. So we tried to knock that out with Cobra the week before, and I think that worked pretty well. And the Texas Panicum was 5 to 10 inches tall, and we're showing the control at 3 weeks after treatment, which is generally a long enough period of time to tell how well clethodim is going to control grass weeds, especially if I move back and you compare that to on treated control. This is where we had clethodim, cropple, and miravis. Statistically, no difference in the grass control. We've got some broadleaves coming in, but from a grass standpoint, we have good control there. This is miravis plus elatus. So again, the leaf spot material and the stem rot material, and no differences in control there compared to clethodim and cropple by itself. And then this is clethodim, cropple, miravis, and convoy. So again, from a grass control standpoint, no difference in those treatments. Now, one thing to keep in mind when we apply clethodim, my recommendation is to always use cropple concentrate. So I didn't notice any difference in any kind of burn on the tissue when we had any of these fungicides in there. One of the questions whenever we apply mixtures and have adjuvants like a cropple concentrate, how does it affect where the materials are that get towards the base of the plant that are controlling stem rot? So that is one of the questions that we haven't addressed in this study. We may try to put out a study to see if there's any impact. But again, from a grass control standpoint, it looks like you can apply miravis plus the stem rot materials, or elatus, or convoy. Now, there are other stem rot materials, but these are the ones that in theory can give you the same amount of stem rot control that you would get with the leaf spot control for miravis. So that matches up quite well for the control. The last study I want to talk about for the CHROME Field Day today is looking at clethodim applied with dual magnum, Zidua, and Anthem Flex. So again, these are the materials that we looked at with Gramoxone. We didn't have room in this particular study for Warrant and for Outlook, but these are the newer ones that we have questions about. And the idea here is all these materials do give us broadleaf control, the residuals, but they also give us some grass control. So it might not be uncommon to put clethodim with these materials. Now, historically, we've looked at dual magnum with clethodim and not seen any issues from a grass control standpoint, but we wanted to see if that was the case with Zidua and Anthem Flex. So again, what we're looking at here is the impact of these materials on the grass control with clethodim. And again, 15 gallons per acre, 31 psi, 110-02 flat fans. We put cobra out a week ahead to get the broadleaves out of the way so that we had grasses and we didn't have any interference with the deposition of these mixtures on the grasses, and we looked at control 3 weeks after. And this is an untreated control. And again, what we found with these mixtures is that there was no difference in the grass control with clethodim when we put these materials into the tank. And again, just to be clear, we're not looking at the residual control in this short period of time. I'm mainly concerned about whether when you apply clethodim, if you get less grass control when you put one of these residual herbicides in relative to the grasses that are already up. So that's the biggest question I was asking or wanted to know in this study. And in doing so, we had very similar control across the board with our residual mixtures or clethodim by itself. And so it looks like these are compatible. And just to give you a couple of quick pictures of those, this is the clethodim at 16 ounces and the crop oil. Spray June 24th. These ratings were taken around July 17th in that ballpark. And this is with dual magnum. And we've done a good bit of work with clethodim and dual magnum and not seen any major issues. We have also done work with I think Outlook in that treatment listing too a couple of years ago and didn't see any issues there. So none there. Then with Zidua, we didn't see any issues here from a control of what had emerged, nor with the Anthem Flex, at least in these particular studies. Now, the way we've put these studies, we're probably not going to be able to get a good feel of more whether that you have more or less residual from these materials for the grass. We might expect that maybe with the Zidua and Anthem Flex, but that would be something we would address in a different study.